Now let us check this question. It is saying, suppose the letter A, B, C, D, E, A, B, C, D, E have probabilities of probabilities 1 by 2, 1 by 4, 1 by 8, 1 by 16, 1 by 32 respectively. Okay, now the question they are asking is, which of the following is the Huffman code? Is the Huffman code for the letters A, B, C, D, E? Option A, it is 0, 10, 1110, 1110, 1111. Option B, 11, 10, 011, 010, 001. Option C is 11, 10, 01, 001, 0001. And option number D is 110, 010, 010, 001. So assume we have this question. Now this question is saying, which of the following is representing the Huffman code of for these letters? And there's a second part of this question which is saying, this is the first part of this question. The second part of this question is saying, what is the average length of the correct answer to the above question? What is the average length? What is the average length of the correct answer? Of the correct answer to the above question. To the above question. And option is, option number A, 3, option number B, 2.1875, option number C is 2.25, and option number D, 1.781. Okay, we have these options. Now let us try to solve this question. Let us try to find out what is the answer. Now here, instead of giving the actual values, that is, instead of giving that A is repeated these many times, B is repeated these many times, C is repeated these many times, they have given the probabilities of the occurrences of A, probability of the occurrence of B, probability of the occurrence of C, D and E. They have given the probabilities. Now when you have the probability, now you know that A is going to at least occur 1 by 2 times, or half of the times A is going to occur, 25% of the times B is going to occur, 12.5% of the times C is going to occur, and so on, right? So better ways, if they have given some kind of probabilities like this, then you convert these probabilities to numbers, right? Because they are saying, let me convert these probabilities to the numbers like this. I'm going to write letters, probabilities and numbers. Okay, and here the occurrences of A, B, C, D and E, these are letters, these are probabilities and these are numbers. So probability of A is 1 by 2, B is 1 by 4, C is 1 by 8, D is 1 by 16 and E is 1 by 32. To convert these probabilities to number, now multiply them to a number by which all of them can be divided, right? Or you can say multiply them by a number which can be divided by all of them. For example, if I take a number which is 32, if I multiply every one of them by 32, so if you do 32 multiplied by 1 by 2, you can get 16, 32 multiplied by 1 by 4, you can get 8, 32 divided by 1 by 8, you can get 4, 32 divided by 1 by 16, you can get 2, and 32 divided by 1 by 32, you can get 1. Now these numbers are showing the occurrences. I'm going to, here I assume that in total we have 32 digits, then in 32 digits, how many occurrences of A can be there? How many occurrences of B can be there? How many occurrences of C, D, and E can be there? Now you know the number of occurrences. Using these number of occurrences, you can find the Huffman code. Okay, so let us try to find the Huffman code. After this, first of all, you have to use the number which is having the minimum length. Okay, so or you can say minimum number of occurrences. So let me extend this table so that I can solve it easily like this. Okay, so the minimum number of occurrences here will be of E and D. So we are going to add E to the left. I'm just drawing it like in we are solving in a paper, in a question paper, because we are not going to waste a lot of time in creating a heap and so on. That is the procedure which they have given in the books, that you have to create a heap and in, from the heap you have to take the minimum value. But if we are going to follow that procedure, it is going to take a lot of time for us to solve the problem. So here I'm just going to solve like how I used to solve in the papers. So here we have E, which is 1, and D, which is 2. So E is having the minimum 1. So A is representing 1 and D is representing 2. So I'm going to add them like this in this node, and 1 plus 2 is 3. So I'm going to represent them by one more node, which is ED, whose occurrence is 3. Now, out of all of them, out of these and this 3, what is the minimum occurrence? Minimum occurrence is E. So I'm going to add this ED on the left and right. Next, what is the next minimum occurrence? That is of C. So I'm going to add this C on the right. So we add C with occurrence 4 on the right, so we can get 3 plus 4 is 7. Therefore, these 3 can be represented by number 7, which is representing E, D, and C. Which is representing E, D, and C. Now, I have B. Now, I have to put this B out of this 16, 8, and 7. What is the minimum value? Minimum value is 7. So, we have to add 7 on the left. And on the right, we can add B because B is 8. So we have B, which is representing 8. So in total, we have 7 plus 8, which is 15. Okay. And then this 3 is representing 15. E, D, C, and B are representing 15. Now next, take the next two minimums. So 15 is the minimum. Next minimum is 16. So we take 16 here, which is representing A, and we add it like this. So 15 plus 16 is 31. So you see, this is the Huffman, this is the tree we are getting. Now we want to identify what is the code we can use. There are two ways of identifying. Either you can take 0 on the left and 1 on the right. If I'm taking 0 on the left, 1 on the right, 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, 1. In that case, E can be represented by 0, 0, 0, 0. D can be represented by 0, 0, 0, 1. C can be represented by 001, B can be represented by 01, and A can be represented by 1, like this. Now, do we have any code which is representing like this? No, we don't have any code. Now, instead of zeros, let us take 1 on the left side. So, instead of 0, let us take 1 here and 0 on the right side. 1 here, 0 on the right side. 1 here, 0 on the right side. 1 here and 0 on the right side. If I take a code like this, then you can see A can be represented by 0, B can be represented by 10, C can be represented by 110, D can be represented by 1110, and E can be represented by 1111. Now, is it matching with any code? Yes, it is matching with the option number A. So you can see option number A is the correct answer to this problem. Now, they are asking what is the average length of the correct answer to the above question. Average length of the correct answer to the above question. It means that if I'm going to represent this symbol A by one character, if I'm going to represent the symbol B by two characters, symbol C by three characters, then in total what will be the average length? Now to find the average length, we have to multiply this average length by the occurrences, right? So you cannot find it like this. You can find it like this. So the A is going to occur 1 by 2 times, 1 by 2 into the average length of A, it is of 1 bit, plus B is occurring 1 by 4 times, so 1 by 4 into average length of B is 2, plus 1 by 8 into length of C is 3, plus 1 by 16 into length of D, which is 4, plus 1 by 32 into length of E, which is 5. So which is 4, length of E is 5. So length of E is E can be represented by 1111, so it is 4. So if you multiply it, so you can get the answer which is 1.781, which is option number D. So the correct answer to this problem is option number D, and the first answer is option number A. So I hope this much is enough for Huffman code.